morning. I'm Alberto García, I come from the Technical University of Catalonia. Yesterday, my colleague Laia Ferrer presented three examples of electric implementations in Peru. And today, I will focus in a mathematical model that we developed to obtain design solutions and a multi-criteria procedure to decide how to choose between these solutions. The presentation will go as follows. I will first introduce the problem and its context, followed by the objective. Then I will explain the mathematical model and the multi-criteria procedure that we propose. And I will give an example of how to apply our methodology to decide the design of a project. And I will end with a conclusion. Well, as Laia explained yesterday, some microwind systems have been recently implemented in communities of Peru. And because of the dispersion of these communities, a manual design tends to use individual systems. However, if we consider the possibility of microgrids and also hybrid technology, PV wind technology, we can obtain several benefits. For instance, we can reduce the cost of the initial investment, and also we don't constrain the energy available in a household according to its location. The objective of this study is to present an optimization model to design PV wind electrification projects, considering the existence of microgrids and also taking into account technical, economical, and also social constraints. With this model, we can obtain several solutions, and to choose between these solutions, we need a multi-criteria process. An example of a design will be this one. We have two microgrids, and this microgrid energy supplied by two PV generators, in this one by four wind turbines, and we have two individual systems. Well, the mathematical model has to do several decisions. In fact, these decisions are the solution of the design. The model has to decide how many wind and PV generators and how many of star will be used and where to allocate them. The same decision for wind and PV controllers, batteries, and inverters. Also, has to decide how many microgrids and the topology of them. Considering that we need to install electric meters on all uses of the microgrids. And also has to decide which kind of wires are used in the microgrids to distribute the electricity. The mathematical model that we propose is in fact a mixed integer mathematical programming model. This kind of programmation allows us to formulate complex combinatorial problems, as it is this design problem. The advantage of using this model is that we use a general modeling language, and to solve the model, we can use a specific software. In our computational experiments, we use commercial software, but there is also free software. Another very important advantage is that this kind of programmation is very modular, so we can change very easily the model to adapt it for every specific project. The idea of the model is that First, we need to define an objective function. This function is to measure the solutions and know which one is better than another. Possible objective functions are, for instance, the initial investment cost, or the replacement cost, or the energy that we supply. In the case of Peru, we use as objective function the investment cost. Also, we need to give the model some constraints. An obvious one is that we need to satisfy the demand of the households. And also, we need to consider technical constraints as water drops or power relations between inverters, controller, and generators. The model needs an input data. In this case, the input data is the locations of the households and the demand of their energy and power. Also, we need to know the available types of solar and wind turbines, their cost and their technical characteristics. The same information for batteries, inverters, controllers, wires, and electric meters. And also, we need a map of the solar and wind resource. Given this information to the model gives us a solution, a design solution. The way that the model gives us a solution is by setting values to our variables. And I will explain what are these of variables in the next slide. I won't show all the full model because it's quite large, but I will see only a part of the model to see how it looks like. We have the variables. For instance, a group of variables will be this one, say, that tell us the number of micro wind turbines that we of each type that we use at each pole of the community, and also similar variables for wind controllers, solar controllers, solar turbines, batteries, etc. We define the objective function. I say that is the initial investment cost. The initial investment cost is the sum of the all costs of the elements. That is the cost of the wind generators that we use, the solar generators that we use, batteries, controllers, inverters, wires, and electric meters. And we define a list of constraints. For instance, the energy that we can store in batteries, the limit of the voltage drops, balances of energy and power, satisfy the demand, etc. So, at this point we can ask if it is worth to consider microwinds and also a hybrid technology. I will use the three projects that I explained in Campo Alegre, Alto Perú, and La Lumbre. And we compare the solution using individual systems or considering the existence of microgrids. And also using wind technology or hybrid technology. I put the cost of the initial investment if we compare wind technology versus hybrid technology, in all cases we can save a lot of money in the investment cost. And if we see the advantage of using microgrids, we can see in Alumbre that we can also save quite money. In Alto Perú the same, but in Campo Alegre we say that we don't save the money. That means that even we allow to use microgrids, the model tells us that the optimal solution is use individual systems. However, I think that there is a big difference between using the model or not using when we implement this solution of individual systems in Campo Alegre. The difference is that without using the model, we implement the solution, but we don't know how good is the solution. However, if we use the model, we implement the same solution, but knowing that that's the optimal solution. The moment I only comment technical constraints, but the model can also consider social constraints. In the case of Peru, we consider two kinds of social constraints. One relates to improved safety and continuity of energy supply. We consider these two, that a minimum percentage of energy is generated through the most stable source. In the case of Peru, it's the solar source. And we consider a minimum number of generators are placed at each generation point. And this is done to guarantee a minimum supply in case of a breakdown. Other kind of self-constraints are to facilitate management. For instance, that all users have meters, not only the microgrid users, but also individual users. And this is done to use a tariff proportional to the consumption of the electricity. We can constrain a minimum number of uses for microgrid to avoid too small microgrids, a maximum number of individual users to promote microgrids, or a maximum number of microgrids to facilitate the management. By combining these optional constraints and different values of the limits, we produce different solutions with the model. To choose between the different solutions, which every solution has is their own advantage and disadvantage, we are working in a multi-criteria process. In a multi-criteria procedure, we consider different criteria in the solutions. Social criteria are the ease of management, the fairness, the economic with respect to the tariff that users pay, the household benefits, community services, productive uses, and impacts on local resources. And technical criteria are the economic, the initial investment cost, the quantity of energy supply, resource continuity, flexibility, if in the case that demand increase, local parts, local manufacturing, and security in the supply. Because this criteria has not the same importance, we need to weight each step. The weights are set by a group of experts and should be done for each particular project. Now I will give an example of how can we apply this methodology. And I will give a project of electrification in 22 households in a community of Peru, called Alto Peru. Are the houses in the red circles. First, we need the input data for the model. We need the location of the 22 households, the demand of energy and power of the households, and the how many autonomy days we want. Also, the cost and characteristics of the technologies, turbines, batteries, etc., and the map of the wind and solar sources. It is interesting to consider alternatives of different scenarios. For instance, we can ask what happens if we want to supply 20% more of energy and power, or if we want to increase the autonomy in 50% more, or if we want to ensure that 25% of energy comes from PV systems. Or if we install the meters on all users, not only on microgrid users.